Salam alaikum. Bonjour. Good morning from Athens, Greece. It is my great pleasure to address myself to a dynamic audience of the event of Algeria 2.0. Having worked for almost 3 years in the Algerian ICT market, I do believe that there is a huge potential of a rapid yet vital growth. Algeria and most of African countries are trying to seize the opportunity of restructuring their economies and find a position in the new world economic order that is being established under the so-called fourth industrial revolution. The opportunities with robotics, 3D printing, artificial intelligence, renewable energies, and the broad accessibility to knowledge are equal for all, no matter the continent and the country they live in. The Western nations that led the three previous industrial revolutions have unevenly exploited the human and natural resources in Africa for centuries. Now it is the best time to put an end to this disequilibrium and develop in cooperation with them as partners and not as exploiters. Spearheading this effort are the millions of young entrepreneurs, scientists, engineers, and innovators who strive to build the blocks of their societies for the present and the future. This effort often faces scarcity of financial resources and resistance from those who refuse to invest in major infrastructure works and establish the right regulatory frameworks. But it has a unique, common, across the countries and industries task, that of building trust and protecting trust. The basis for this major transformation are the digital networks that allow an increasing number of online everyday services and habits. Mobile phones, covering the basic needs for vocal and digital communication, are used to access financial services, public services, distance learning, e-health, agricultural, and an unlimited number of other economic and social activities. More than 650 million citizens in Africa, where mobile phone penetration is close to 50% of the total population and growing fast, use these existing networks for internet services. For this transition to happen fast and smoothly, a major asset is required: trust. Trust is the foundation upon which a multiple of superstructure of applications, initiatives, and services is being built. Many parts and parties in this transformation need to be trusted: the reliability of the networks, the security of the data centers, the secure storage of sensitive data of citizens, the encrypted transmission of data, the robustness of mobile phones and the other terminal devices. Each one of the above is a challenge that has to be addressed and protected in the best possible way according to the current level of science and techniques. Today, I shall focus on a major block in building trust, that of authentication of users. Identity fraud, account hijacking, and takeover are skyrocketing, along with the exponential growth of online users and the multitude of online services, especially due to the pandemic. The fraudsters and criminals manage to get access to sites in the name of the certified users in order to reap, directly or indirectly, multiple monetary and other benefits. They are focusing on the sectors and industries which mostly provide these benefits, like the financial sector, the public sector, health, insurance, and distance learning. Every successful fraudulent attack costs millions to the service provider and headaches to millions of their users. The monetary, operational, and reputational costs are very big and growing. The consequences can be unpredictable, as the size of the attacks may be enormous. Moreover, mistrust about the robustness of the services discourages users to adopt more online services. Today, in 2021, all authentication methods used during the last decades are compromised, hence insecure. Username and passwords, still the dominant method for accessing sites, have been the easy target to be phished and stolen. Besides their manifest vulnerability, they require a considerable technical and operational cost for the provider in order to manage lost, forgotten, and stolen passwords. Secure tokens used for one-time passwords were soon compromised, and they represented a difficult to manage logistically solution. SMSs or in-app one-time passwords were also intercepted either by SIM cloning or device thefts. In addition, sending SMSs constitutes a considerable direct cost. Biometrics, mainly face recognition and fingerprints, have become recently the mostly used authentication methods. Ironically, both of these factors are openly exposed daily as we leave our fingerprints everywhere and cameras are capturing our face at any time. Although convenient, they do provide risks. All of the above are used in order to log into a site and in order to perform some specific type of transactions. For example, I log in into a bank account with fingerprint and enter an one-time password I receive on my mobile phone by SMS in order to transfer an amount to a third party. It is true that two-factor or multi-factor authentication methods are more robust, although not so convenient as the single one. So today, as we speak, the best method is the continuous behavioral authentication. Best in terms of security, privacy, convenience, and cost effectiveness. What is this relatively new method? It refers to, first, the ways with which a user that accesses a site interacts with a device that he or she is using to do so, like the mobile phone, the tablet, or the PC. For example, the keyboards of all devices track down a number of characteristics when a user is keying in data. The speed of keystrokes, the number of fingers used, the pressure of the keys or the screen, and so on. The mouses or mouse pads used are recording the speed we use them, the frequency, the pressure, the scrolling down or up. The touch screens record the speed and the direction we swipe them. The mobile devices record the angle with which we hold them using the gyroscopes. Seconds are the conditions under which the device is used. For example, the geolocation of the device during the session, the proximity with other trusted devices, the IP or MAC address, the speed of movement of the device, of our movement. Third is the type of some transactions that are performed. For example, the trusted beneficiary, the frequency we make a transaction, the amounts that are being handled, or the timing, the time that we perform transactions. And fourth, two biometric factors, face recognition and fingerprints. All these factors or traits can and are recorded by the devices themselves by the systems under which they operate and by specific service provider who owns the site accessed by the user. Each one of these 14 factors, characteristics, by itself may not be strong enough to authenticate the user. But all these recorded traits are fusioned with the use of artificial intelligence in order to create a profile of the user that is absolutely unique. These digital traits are encrypted by the device and sent through an encrypted channel to the artificial intelligence application in a cloud. After a short period of machine learning, this unique profile is created and securely stored in safe cloud infrastructure. This profile constitutes the key for accessing the site. This key is not repetitive, or 8 characters long, or 4, or a combination of letters and numbers, or a few dozen almost unique points of our biometrics. This key is about 2 gigabyte big and is not circulating on paper in our phones or wherever other keys used to, but encrypted in secure clouds. This method guarantees the uniqueness and robustness of our keys. But the story does not end there. As I mentioned before, users are authenticated not only to log in sites, but in order to perform some higher risk transactions, like changing our personal data or transferring money to a third party. The proposed solution performs authentication continuously during all the session where the user is accessing the service. Every few seconds during the session, all of the above traits are sent to the artificial intelligence module, are fusioned to a profile which is compared to the established profile key of the user. If the two match, with a very small statistical error, the user is allowed to perform any transaction without having to enter anything in the device. If the continuously generated profile is not meeting the allowed threshold of security of the service provider, then, according to the policy, the user can be challenged to provide some additional information, like fingerprints, or the session is closed and the user is not allowed to continue. In this way, independently of the method the user has logged in the site, this solution guarantees the authenticity, protecting from any account takeover and any non-authorized person to use the service. Given the high percentage of internal fraud in companies, this is the only method that protects the providers and the users from fraudulent attacks. This solution protects the privacy of the users. In order to sign to the service, they have to consent to the collection of the traits mentioned above. But at any time, they can stop the service and delete all data gathered in order to build this profile, including the profile. The cloud used can be either an international accepted one or a cloud mandated by company or national regulation and policy. The installation of this solution is performed remotely in a matter of days. During Algeria Summit 2.0, this solution is presented by a startup company called Quadible that has a virtual stand with documentation, and the young entrepreneurs are happy to answer any of your questions. So please visit it and get also digital documentation. Thank you very much for your attention, and I will be glad to answer any questions that may have arisen. Merci beaucoup, Saha.